we got involved in a project with the University of Calgary, and it was the University of Calgary capstone project. It's the fourth year engineering students need a project to go out and test the skills that they've learned in the university. And so one of the things that we were really interested in was Trihedral had come out with a JSON driver for VTScada. And that JSON driver just allows connectivity to all sorts of different products that are starting to come on the marketplace. And so with the students, we kind of put together the scope of work and we said, hey, what we want to see is when the video analytics detects something that's abnormal or different, that we can therefore alarm it in VTScada. And with that timestamp, we know exactly when the event occurred and we can go find that on the video if we'd like to watch it again. So this video that we're now going to look at actually shows that to us. And where we are right now is we're actually currently looking out the actual face of the drone. We can actually go ahead and map where the drone's going to fly or what pattern it's going to fly on. And so it will now go out and find itself, fly at a little search pattern. And what it's searching for, and this is all automated, it is searching for a blue square. As it takes off up here, it's going to go to the first waypoint, and all the way along the way it is searching, so the video analytics are running. And as it proceeds here, it will come to the first waypoint and it will not find what it's looking for. Then it also drops out further to circle at a greater distance. Once that occurs, we will move on to the next waypoint. So while it's doing that, what we really found as we went through this exercise was that we could accomplish some of the things that we were looking for, which was to get the video analytics to happen right on the camera, or in this case, right on the drone with the camera. And the reason that's really interesting is because we use a thousandth to a millionth of the video that we actually take. So when you look at video that's happening at like 6 frames per second or more, all of that data gets stored and put someplace, but nobody ever looks at it because they had no reason to look at it. The only time they need to look at it is when an event occurs. So here we come up, we found the item, an alarm just came in, you can see on the left-hand side into VTScada, telling us that we actually found the blue square. And with that timestamp, we can now reference it back to the video and know exactly where to look. And so that was really the intent of this. Instead of having all sorts of video that we had to constantly stream, so we acknowledged it, and once again, you'll see that alarm come back in again after we've acknowledged it. So the ease of providing this interface was really, really impressive. We did this project on VTScadaLIGHT, which is a 50-tag free license providing a thin client, allows you to use all the functionality of VTScada. VTScadaLIGHT itself allows 10 free licenses to anybody or any corporation that wants to make use of it. We almost have a little internal competition going on here at BetsM to see who can do the most creative, interesting things with VTScadaLIGHT. So this was certainly one of the first ones that we're demonstrating. It didn't take the students very long to integrate it into VTScada. They did most of the integration into VTScada in an afternoon. And really, most of their effort was spent developing the video analytic programs and things like that, as well as develop the automation on the drone. We look forward to working with other video analytic companies. I think we proved the concept. Going forward, we think we have probably one of the best platforms to be able to provide this type of solution. Going back to the fundamentals, we should have a common alarming, we should have common visualization, and we should only really have to train on one product for operation staff. So here we are after a successful journey. This was completely automated. There was no pilot at the helm other than a computer, and we thought it was pretty impressive.